people who leave, that's he who else would it be? Take your lady Mercedes, hold this shit to your face, disgrace at a slow pace, go over.
John and the Fox! Yeah, yeah, West End, come on. North Side, come on. Jim,
John and the Fox!
Yeah, yeah.
Like I said, JP Express, okay, you know, he had a DJ like Dr. Smooth, you had Tomahawk, had a lot of these cats that was straight out the house that was really, really putting it down and doing these house parties and stuff like that. On the radio, the Z-Rock crew and the Churchill crew, that what got me because I could put the tape on record and just fall asleep, and the next day I got a dope tape. You know what I mean?
Fresh Fresh Tours. Run DMC.
Inside of Richmond, we had a party every weekend. You know what I'm saying? You know, it was like we had parties, we had shows at the arena, you know what I mean, at the Arthur Ashe, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, we did Richmond thoroughly.
Houdini, the Fat Boys.
I remember he went on the attack.
Yeah.
Oh, and the rhyme, he said, B-Boys ain't nothing. No, I was like, oh my God. He got him that night.
He could outrun everybody, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I freely admit that. You know, I was just holding my skills. he was a real
man.
Yeah, he was definitely a real beast back in the day.
First line said, before I came to this party, I prepared to rock, smoke sesame, or drink private stock. And he looked at me, he was like, wow. And everybody was like, okay, what are we gonna call you?
Cause he did it, he did it with confidence. He did it like, he sounded like professional, even though we was all like teenagers.
Now I was bit by the DJ bug. I started concentrating a lot more on the DJ than I did on the MC. And MC was still in my heart.
Whatever it takes to get a couple of dollars, cause the key is publishing that jazz when you get some. You know what I'm saying?
My man YG, he was a promoter at the time. He was bringing a lot of shows. We were like the act that mostly headlined the bill. We did a lot of shows from the Abbey to the Night Gallery to the classic Ebony Island, which is around the corner on North Avenue, where all the hustlers, slash this and slash that, and the fly girls and all, everybody congregated. If you was anybody that was somebody, you was at the Ebony Island.
Grandmaster Jay Miller C and them, Tolliver, Bates Disco. Like I said, I stayed so underground and stayed to myself. You know, not trying to be selfish, just trying to, you know, get my own music up, you know what I'm saying? So those are the main ones that really come to my mind. Beast from the East, you know what I'm saying? Black Burn, all them, you know what I'm saying?
My cousin had recorded a record with a guy by the name of MC Honeybun. And rest in peace, Honeybun. So I can remember they gave me the mic. Honeybun walks in, so it was a group of rappers there that night. It was the Royal Sound Crew. It was the mic controllers. It was Honeybun. It was Booney. It was a guy named Michael Wright. He was there.
Boombox, and you put your cassette in, and you had a pause button ready. So it was a new song that you hadn't heard before, one that you didn't have, you were recorded off of the radio.
AJ, Wiggy Wiggy, then my brother and my man Jarrell Steele, who's no longer with us, rest in peace, introduced me to a radio station called WKIE, and they played records from these guys called the Skinny Boys. Yeah, Skinny Boys, you know what I mean?
We messed around for a few years, we didn't have any original music, we used to mix tape deck to tape deck. You know, taking a break beat and an old record, mixing that up, trying to come up with something new, overdubbing it from another tape to add new stuff to it and stuff like that.
There was nothing bigger than the Fresh Fest. And I was lucky enough, along with my man Grandmaster Jay, to be the DJs and the host.
I went into breakdancing first. I always wanted to be a DJ. And I started scratching on a turntable when I saw Herbie Hancock's video for Rocket. And I saw Grand Mix of DST in the joint. And, you know, that's I got into it from there. Then from there, I went to dancing. I was with Frank Lester, Andre Lester, You know, Charmaine, that's my sister, Jeff, Aisha.
There's a club in the West End called 2001, I want to say. And they used to have a breakdance contest also, which brings me to the breakdancer crews, specifically the Interlocks and the Floor Controllers. They were both from Southside. And it's funny because there's a neighborhood connection there where I lived across the street from two of the guys from the Interlocks. And the Floor Controllers, Divine Mecca, my partner, lived right across the street from. So we, you know, in fact, we wrote a song for the Interlocks.
I remember Massenburg from Church Hill. This is the cool Herc of Richmond.
Kid sensation.
That's it. He was the cool Herc. I mean, this guy had house speakers in the back of his car. He stepped it up to his van, you know what I mean? And you could count on this guy to come through that if the house party wasn't hitting. Matter of fact, he could make people come out of the house party outside in the streets. Way he had this kid sensation, right?
DJ Ramon was ahead of his time. He was, you know, ahead of his time. He was doing like Dr. Dre type stuff, you know, with the skits and the sound effects and, you know, giving you that, like, that real full effect, you know, on his mixtapes.
Sometimes when I make my beats, I think about, you know, how this a sound to this certain type of commercial. So I have a vision in my head. So I always have a vision, like when I'm at work or whatever, I always have a rhythm in my head, and if I think I might forget, I write it down, put it away somewhere.
I remember Ivory's and Polo Bay and Farmville, Fevers.
Central Virginia, I gave Kirby Carmichael and Lump. I had a mix with that Mr. Magic had did with African Bambaataa. That was our Planet Rock and the Numbers. And it was a Mr. Magic master mix. And they used to play it at Skateland because I was the only one that had it.
The B side basically came from, first and foremost, as a DJ in this game, the A side of any piece of wax that we got was usually the radio cut. The B side was always that underground knocker that you had. So we took that from that. It also stands for El Bravador. It also stands for Chris Brooks.
Gotta give props to DJ Sir RJ, because DJ Sir RJ was really the first one to ever put me in the lab. And we haven't spoken in years, so he might not even remember this right now until he looks and listens, remember the story, see my face, just remember a young brother, Breeze, from back in the day.
RJ has connects.
Yeah. RJ, I just saw RJ on a Sprite, I mean a Mountain Dew flyer, a Mountain Dew billing. He did some stuff for Mountain Dew. RJ's done stuff for Mountain Dew. He's out there doing his records, his Dirty South records.
Yeah.
And he's got a dance now. There's a dance from RJ's record.
They do a line dance.
A line dance.
Back in those
days. Oh my God, that was it.
Okay.
That was truly it. I think that was it more than anything else, the battling and just freestyling. So it really wasn't that I had, songs that had a label or whatever to it. I remember doing a battle. What was the guy's name that used to be with this movie? I can't think of his name right now, but he was a producer. And he always had things like at Ebony Island and the different places where he would put out for us to come out and battle females and male rappers.
You got the proof in the pudding, you got the flyers and all that. So if anybody want to test it, you know what I'm saying? We ain't hard to find. We in the hood, you know what I'm saying?